Is how to plant out your sweet corn. Now this is my sweet corn here. It has been growing beautifully. Sweet corn is a tender crop, so you need to make sure that all worry of frost has gone from your area before you plant it out. Now I sowed my sweet corn in a tray and I sowed two seeds together. Now some of the little groups are both seeds have germinated, and others only one has, and in some none have. In fact, I think only out of all of these, only three little groups haven't germinated. Now if you have got two plants growing together in a little group, I am not going to separate those. I will grow those together, because if you separate them, then you might disturb the roots and you might actually break the stem. So they will grow quite happily, just two plants together. Now this variety is called Amaize, so they are now ready to go outside into the big garden. So I will show you how to do those. Now, if you are growing various varieties of sweet corn, only keep them separate, way, way separate. And I'm talking about if you want to save the seeds for some next year, you will need to grow them, I would suggest, at least 4 meters apart from each other. Now, sweet corn needs to grow in a block. So if you've got, say for example, 12 plants, grow them 3 plants by 4 plants. They shouldn't grow in a line, because what they do to pollinate themselves is they need to grow into a block, so that when they send off their pollen, then it can swish round and get all of them, because they're in a block. If they're in a line, then it just doesn't work. So if you want to harvest them to save some seeds for the following year, you need to make sure that you keep different varieties way, way apart from each other. But if you're just going to get new seed next year, then then they can grow fairly close to each other. I have got 5 different plants here. They're either mini pop or they're strawberry. Now the reason I don't know is because at work they were left over and they didn't have a label in the bag, so it's one or the other, so it's going to be a surprise as to find out what they are. So that's why I brought them home. I was allowed to bring them home, which was wonderful. So they're over there, so I'm going to plant these Amaize on this side of the bed. Now I've got 11 groups here, so I am going to sow them. I'm going to do a 4 and I'll do some 3s as well. So let me show you how I plant these out into the ground. Right, so I have broken the little clumps apart from each other. Their roots are doing really well down the bottom. There's loads of them. Now when you plant your sweet corn out, you need to make sure that they are at least 12, well, they shouldn't be any closer than 12 inches close. If you can get them a little wider, a little further apart, then I would suggest, please do try. Now I'm growing these in amongst the pumpkins, which is absolutely fine, because the pumpkins will grow round them, and these sweet corn, they produce stuff on the top, whereas the pumpkins produce on the bottom. So I'm going to put them just dotted around here. They will be in a clump, but not, you know, regimented. So what I'm going to do, let me just move that out of the way and then you can see, is I'm going to dig a nice deep hole. Now remember, these will get tall, so if you can get them as low in the ground as possible, that would just make them a little bit more sturdy. So I've got a lovely deep hole of about, I would guess, about 4 or 5 inches deep. I'm then going to put my sweet corn in the hole and then just fill round. Make sure that you push it in well, like this, and then I will put another one here, and I will just carry on doing all of these. So once I've got them all in, then I will show you. Well, I've just got them all in. There's some here, they're all kind of dotted about, but they're in this sort of this half of the bed. All I'm going to do now is to give them a really good water. If you have a problem with slugs and snails, then protect them from slugs and snails. But when they get a little bit bigger, then they'll just be too big for the slugs and snails to bother with. So I'll keep an eye on those, keep them watered well. They'll settle in very, very quickly. And then hopefully soon they'll just get as big as the other ones over there. And then maybe, you know, give it a couple of months and hopefully they'll start to produce their little cobs. So that will be very exciting because I do like sweet corn. Anyway, so that's the sweet corn. And apart from some flowers and some herbs, all the veggies are in. I've just got a few more peas to put in, but I've already shown you how to put peas in. And so I'm just sowing new peas every month. So I will plant those peas out. I think I'll do them in a pot in a wigwam this time. And yes, I think we're getting there. So it's all very exciting. I've still got a load of fruit to do, but all the veggies are in. Let's just hold on to that one. Well, I hope you found that useful, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.